So then guys, today I'm going to show you how to transfer all your apps and data from your old iPhone to a brand new iPhone, and it's so easy to do it. So I'm going to get started with this video straight away and take these iPhones over to the desk. I'm going to be using an iPhone SE, the second generation, and I'm going to be transferring all the data off this over to my brand new iPhone 14 Pro Max. But you can do this with any iPhone that is available right now that is running on iOS 16. You will basically get exactly the same guide sort of instructions for your iPhone. But like I said, let's go over to the desks and let's start doing the transfer. And the first transfer I'm going to do is I'm going to do a direct transfer from the iPhone SE to the iPhone 14. And then after that, I'm going to do the other transfer of doing it. And that is how you can transfer all your data via the iCloud. But first of all, let's just do a direct transfer first.
So what we want both iPhones available. And what we want to do is we want to get your brand new iPhone, just like the iPhone 14 Pro Max here, get the screen open, and there we go. It's automatically saying to set up a new iPhone, press continue. So we're gonna press that on the older phone, and it should just connect to the new phone. As you can see here, I have this weird kind of picture appearing with blue dots and everything. But pick up your other phone with the camera and sort of get it into the lens like it says here. And what this is going to do is just gonna transfer things like Wi-Fi information, and also like your account details of your iCloud and things like this. So as you can see here, it's telling us to set up a new account. I'm going to do it as my name, and it's also asking for the code of the other iPad. My one's just going to put that in. And after you put this code in, it will set up your phone. Remember, this is your passcode from your other phone or password, whatever that is. And it's going to take a minute or so to set up your phone by pulling over all that sort of basic information first of all. Then after that, it's going to activate your new phone to make sure it's a brand new phone that's okay to register. This might take a minute or two, so just leave this run and I'm going to skip ahead. And the next step is, if you've either got Face ID or Touch ID, is to set this up. So I've got Face ID on this iPhone 14 Pro Max, and click continue. Gonna click get started. I'm gonna get my face in if I can. Should go into a circle. Let's see if I can get it. Oh, there we go. I've got my light in there as well, but it's okay. The camera's not catching that. And there we go. I've done my face. So it's asking me if I want to set up on a mask. What I don't really want to do at this stage, we don't really have masks in this country, we're okay in the UK, but if you want to set that up, you need to grab yourself a mask and set that up. Next of all is the choices then of where you want to do your downloads or move your data over. In this part of the video, we're going to transfer everything over from the iPhone. So this bottom option that you can see right here. There are other options as well. This is like to set up your phone brand new from fresh, or to set up from an Android phone. And like I said, I will talk about how to transfer everything from iCloud a bit later on in this video. But for now, the main thing is what we're going to do is we're going to transfer everything from the other iPhone. So I'm just going to press that, and it's just setting up our Apple ID here, and this might take a minute or so to complete. And after this, we have the terms and conditions. You can read through them if you want, or just click agree, and it'll continue on setting up your Apple ID. I will mention at this point though, to keep your old iPhone near your new iPhone. And there we go, it's saying everything that they want to transfer over from my iPhone SE to this phone. So it's got all my apps and data settings, my Apple Wallet for example. I might set them up a bit later, I might skip that bit actually. But you guys can do that, set up your wallet and all your cards and everything. But what we can do is we can customize it and change things if we wanted to. But I'm just want to continue on really and move everything over. The customize option basically allows you to turn away some apps, things like this. And this is what I was talking about, my card. I'm gonna set this up later, I've got three of them, do all of this later. Yeah, later. There we go, last card. Is it gonna go? There we go, it's gone. And next thing is iPhone Analytics. I'd recommend to share this with Apple and also App Analytics. And then finally, also emergency SOS for like car detection, crashes and things like that, if your iPhone is compatible with doing that. So what we're going to do is we're just going to leave these two iPhones now. And at this point, you can make yourself a drink or something like this. And then basically just leave this run then for the time being.
So then guys, just quickly, I want to talk about Casetify. Now Casetify right now are having their biggest sale they've ever had this year. You can get a massive 30% off discount, or up to $63 off
by doing this combi that you can see right here.
And it's because of Black Friday. They are doing their biggest sale and they've got some great cases and accessories what you can get for your iPhone 14 model. For example, on my iPhone 14 Pro Max that I have here, I have one of their brand new EcoShock bounce cases. And basically the phone inside this, like your iPhone 14, can be dropped from over 21 foot. Well, it's absolutely amazing. In fact, what I've done is I've done a little tester here to show you guys of dropping my iPhone 14 Pro Max in this case here and seeing what happens. Obviously I'm not dropping it from 21 foot because I can't really gauge that on my camera, but have a look at this video here. So there we go. As you can see here, my phone is in perfect condition. There are no problems on it whatsoever. The screen's intact, the edge of the body, if I just pop it out here, there we go, it's absolutely fine. So that is truly amazing. And the main reason behind this is because these bounce cases have some cool technology inside them. One of them is tension distribution, as you can see here. And you kind of got like a twister sort of design in the inner lining of the case, what helps sort of absorb sort of bounces and hits on the floor, so it doesn't actually impact the actual phone. And one other cool thing that I absolutely love about Case to Buy cases, that I've mentioned this year many times, is actually their cases are made out of 65% recycled material and also plant-based materials inside them too, to give that extra sort of resistance. And talk about that resistance when you saw me dropping the phone in this case. Did you know it's 6 times military grade? And also, the guys at Case to Buy, they actually test their cases 156 times at the top height to make sure that the phone is going to be absolutely fine. Because let's be honest, you're not going to drop your phone for over 20 foot 130 times in its lifetime, most likely. So this gives you that ultimate reassurance. Case to Buy don't just sell cases for your phone either. They also sell screen protectors like I have here on my iPhone 14 Pro Max. I have one of their ones on here. It was really easy to apply and it makes the screen even a bit more stronger. On top of this as well, you might have noticed a bit is a bit of an edge sort of here, a bit of a ridge, and this protects the screen. If it does fall flat on its face, it will protect it with the screen protector, and then also the edging of the case will help that too. But then if you did drop it onto the back of the phone, here onto the case, you can also get here a camera protection sort of lenses, piece of plastic that's over here that protect your lenses from getting scratched because you don't want to damage your cameras. And then finally, to make things even more secure, if you're out hiking, for example, you can also get one of the new straps that you can get here, like I'm dangling my iPhone 14 Pro Max, and attach it to yourself to make sure to give yourself even more safety that you're not actually going to drop your iPhone. So right now, guys, if you're planning on buying yourself a brand new iPhone for Black Friday, I would definitely head over to Case to Buy's website and get yourself one of their cases right now, because like I said, it's the biggest sale they have done this year and you do really want to check it out. And if you do want to check it out, do go to the link that I'm providing at the bottom right now, and I'll also put this in my description of this video. And with that, guys, back to the video.
Once the transfer has fully completed over from your old iPhone, don't get too alarmed that your new iPhone might restart. So there we go, it says transfer complete my old iPhone, and my new iPhone now is just gonna do a restart. So I'm just gonna click continue here, and then erase this iPhone. I'm gonna click not now, I'll show you how to do that a bit later on. But there we go, my new iPhone is booting up with all the data and bits and pieces like that. I'm gonna set mobile services, I've moved my SIM card over because it's a physical SIM inside my iPhone 14 here in the UK. But let's just let that boot up fully. And in the time being, we can actually also remove the iPhone SE because we don't need it anymore. And we can put back into focus the iPhone 14. Oh, there we go, speak of that, it's all fully loaded. That was quick restart. So what we can do is we can unlock the phone. There you go, Face ID. And there we go, all my apps have been fully transferred over from my iPhone SE. What was absolutely amazing. I'm so happy about this. It was easy as that to transfer everything over by doing a direct transfer.
So that was super easy to get everything over to the iPhone 14. I'm really happy that everything's now fully loaded onto it. But there is another way how you can transfer all your data onto your brand new iPhone from the iPhone SE. And that is you can do it via a cloud backup. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show you how to do a cloud backup. I'm gonna wipe my iPhone 14 and I'm gonna show you how to do that process instead now.
So this time you want to start with your old iPhone, your original iPhone, not your new one. On this, you want to go to settings first of all, and we want to make sure we've got a good backup. So you're going to select your name at the top, scroll down to iCloud here, and then you want to scroll down a little bit more, and there should be something called iCloud backup that needs to be switched on if it isn't. And then basically what you want to do is you want to do a backup right now on this page, because this will transfer everything over. So we're going to do a backup now and basically leave this run until it is fully completed. Once this is fully completed, you won't need this iPhone anymore because it's all in the cloud. But do take note of your unlock password, what you should know already, to unlock your iPhone, because you will need this on your new iPhone. So let me move this out of the way and let's bring the new iPhone into the camera's view. So with setting up iCloud, there's a little bit more effort doing it this way, but it's not to worry. What we want to do is we want to click on English. And then we want to do is we want to scroll right down to my country or to your country. My country is the United Kingdom, and we want to set that. Like I said, guys, this method is the best method to do this if basically you don't have your other iPhone handy, if you traded it in or something like that. But basically we want to set it up manually. And then what we want to do is we want to choose your Wi-Fi and put in the password for your Wi-Fi. So I'm just going to do that. Once you're done with this, just click return and it'll connect to your Wi-Fi. This might take a second or two. And then afterwards, your phone needs to activate for the first time, or for a new time as it were, just to check that your phone is legit and it's not locked or anything like that. Once this is completed, you'll get the data and privacy. You just want to click continue on that. We also want to set up Face ID, so I'm just going to click continue here and we're going to get that started. Your phone might also have Touch ID, so just follow the same steps for Touch ID. I'm just circling my face for Face ID and that's done. I don't have a mask, so basically I'm going to say don't set up with using a mask, but you can set it up with a mask, but you do need to go and grab it. So that's it, Face ID is all completed. Next of all, you need to create a passcode. So this is a new passcode, not the one on your last iPhone, a new one. So I'm setting up a basic one here, 123456. Do not use this code, it's not my code either. It's just for the demo of this video. Just a basic code, just to show that we need to put one in. But this is the most important page now of what we want to do. So we have lots of different options here. We're gonna restore from iCloud backup, but there are other options where we can transfer directly from another iPhone, we can transfer from Android, we can set it up brand new this iPhone, don't transfer any apps or data whatsoever, and we can also just restore from a Mac or PC. But I'm doing the iCloud option. And for that, we need to sign into iCloud. So you need to sign in. Once you have signed in, you'll probably get a two-way authentication if you have that set up. So put in your two-way authentication code. This is just a random code. So I've got my old iPhone here, which is telling me that it needs to be set up. I just actually need to get my right thumb on this. Let's put that again. There we go. And there we go. I'm just going to allow myself just to sign in here and put the same code that we're seeing on the screen. So whatever code that you're seeing on your other phone, put this in, or other Apple device, put this into your new iPhone to basically transfer everything over. So we're going to do that over to authenticate iCloud, agree to the terms and conditions to iOS. And there we go. It's just setting up the Apple ID on this new iPhone. This may take a minute or two, but once it has, you want to choose your latest backup that you've done. So as you can see, I've got all my latest backups and everything that I've completed on my iPhones. But the one I want to pick is this iPhone 4 one, the second one down, what was from the iPhone SE second generation. So I'm just going to select that because that's the iPhone we just backed up a moment ago. Might just take a second or two to recognize it. But once it's gone, we'll basically have everything here to say transfer everything over. We'll also have the ability to set up your debit cards or credit cards. I'm going to skip this for now, but you can do this if you want to at this stage, or you can do it later on in settings. So I'm just going to transfer everything like that. I'm also going to share my details with Apple and their app analytics as well for developers, also emergency SOS. And there we go. It's now going to restore all my settings and all my backup, what we did on the iPhone SE earlier, onto this iPhone 14 Pro Max. So again, at this stage, we can just leave this run, make yourself a drink, and let this just do its own business. And also, this will restart as well, potentially. Once everything is completed, we'll get to the main home menu, if you had to do a restart or not, it doesn't really matter. And then basically we just have to open up the screen and there we go. Again, all my apps and everything have been fully restored onto this. You might have to wait a little bit for some apps also to come on here. So I would just leave your iPhone just near your sort of Wi-Fi just to let that settle in as well.
Well, there we have it, folks. The iPhone 14 has got that full iCloud backup on it. And like I said already, that it might take a couple of sort of hours to get all your data back onto it, download all the apps, but just give it a chance, leave it fully charged, or leave it on the charger even, was even better, and leave it close to sort of a Wi-Fi hotspot to get sort of the best speeds to download all your apps and everything back onto it. You may have to sign into your apps again, but quite a lot of the apps out there actually do remember your details, but it depending on the actual app and the developer and how that's all set up. But with that, guys, you're fully set up now on your brand new iPhone and you are ready to go. So with that, guys, it's time to also wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time, if you want to hear the latest reviews, comparisons, and also guides just like this one here today, please also make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye-bye.